Muhammed from 3D Zone Art asked us for an idea for his logo. Since it's an art logo, Muhammed, I thought we'd use the current trend of acidic hues as well as artsy fonts. Let's jump right in on Canva and create this together. Canvas, and you've changed the background. I like using black, but we're going to change it to white a little bit later on. You're going to go to your search elements and you're going to look for tree silhouette. You're then going to go to your graphic silhouettes and then you're going to scroll down until you find a tree that you want to work with. I loved this tree that's called Tree Silhouette with Roots logo designed by Studio Best. You click on it once and you add it to your canvas. You size it and you align it to your canvas to the size that you want. And make sure that your image is editable when it comes to color. Because for this design, we want it to be editable. The first color tree, we're then going to change the color. And we're going to use the beautiful acidic colors that are on trend right now. So we're going to start with a gorgeous green. And we're going to paste the hex code. And then it's changed and we're happy. Then click on crop and start cropping the first section of our image so that we have a four-part color series with our design. And you click on done. Then you're going to duplicate the tree, align it to the first design, and then change the color to a different color. And then it's still selected. You're going to click on crop to the second section. So you're going to move and click on done. Perfect. Then you select the second and you absolutely do exactly the same as you've done. This life is a nuisance, tie up some loose ends. I try to be human, find a solution, my evolution. A place like this, it didn't exist, we made it like this. So you can go pick the bad or the good, got a glass half wish. I know, it's easier to hide than just to lay low. Not everyone in life has got a halo. I'm standing in the red inside. And you click on done. You have a beautiful acidic design. The next step is to add a round border around the tree. So we're going to go to our elements and we're going to search for circle. We're looking for this nice big circle that's called circle, but Google design icons. That's awesome. And we're going to use this around the tree to create the round shape of a tree. Next, we're going to add our rectangle and we're going to change the color of the rectangle and also make it black. When we go to Photopea to convert this to a 3D, we're going to make it completely white. To add the name of the YouTube channel or the company, Muhammed didn't tell me what it was. So you press T for text and we're going to add the text separately so that we can make it artsy. So we want a font that is artsy, so we're going to search for art on our font. And there's different kinds of fonts that are arty, and I love the Art Nuvo. We're going to use that for our design. And in line with the first color, we're going to go with a green D, a green 3 rather. That would be a capital letter, and then you're going to size it and align it to your design, and you're going to rotate it to be in line with the round shape that we're creating over there. Next, you're going to duplicate the 3, and now we want a D that is that shocking pink, and we're going to rotate that and make it straight and align it to our design. I do like when letters are creating gaps between each other. So let's create a gap there using a shape and we make the 3 be on top of the D. Of the turbulence and it's concerning. I've been searching for a purpose. I hope it's worth it. This society is really trying me. Ain't no hide and seek. I hide to be far from anxiety. I need my space. I need my privacy. I need some silence. Please, you're all too loud. You don't. You go to your layers and you want the G behind, the 3 on top, like that. We can make a turn and start reversing. All our minds and put the work in. We got some. Next, we finish our design by adding the rest of the name. Zone art, 3D zone art. The last thing you would do is to make sure that the letters are also rounded. So you pick your circle and you'd make sure that the position of your circle is on top. So you bring it to front and then it cuts it out nicely like that. And it's in sync and it's beautiful. So the last thing that you would do if you want to, you convert this to a 3D art. And you make sure that everything is white. So I just love black. It's not about me. Mohammed, you must tell us if you like this design. I love this design. Anyway, so we're going to change the background and make it white and change all the other shapes. And we also make those white. Change all of them like that. I'm going to go back to our elements and I'm going to add this circle. The thin circle that I think is going to just complete the design. Align it to our art design. I'm then going to repeat the process that we did when we were measuring the tree and aligning the tree and cutting the tree in segments. I'm going to do absolutely the same with this shape that I've added for the circle so that the circle is also in line with the art that we're creating. Back to the mat, gonna see where I'm at. I'ma fight like I'm mad. I'ma be something that they can never be me. Nice try, but they'll see I achieve everything while they stay salty. Another way to make sure that the colors are the same with your art as well as the text, you could download the text on its own and then download it as a PNG. And then you could then add it up and then align it the way that we've aligned the images earlier on so that you have the exact lines on each section. I think you might enjoy that. Awesome. Now that you've created a border that looks like the design itself, you're going to download it and you're going to go to remove.bg and you're going to take off the white. And you're going to download that. Again, you're going to head over to Photopea. You're going to pick a template. I liked this one. You're going to double click where it says your logo here. And you're going to hide the designer's example. Going to add our 2D, size it, change it to smart object by pressing Command S, and then access it on the first tab. There's your design, beautifully done. Let us know in the comments below what you think of the design. If you enjoyed this, go to our playlist and learn more on designs that we've created. Thank you so much for joining me on this video. I will see you next time.